today we'll be talking about scarlet fever and chickenpox. Okay. So scarlet fever vani pukasalai thasa. So I don't know the Nepali term for scarlet fever, but basically this is a fever basically presenting with acute pharyngitis. Okay, upper respiratory tract infection later present versa. It is presenting with acute pharyngitis and tonsillitis and a typical rash. Okay, so the cause of this fever, scarlet fever, is a group A beta hemolytic streptococci, GAS. Group A beta hemolytic streptococci causes this. It secretes a pyrogenic exotoxin, which results in a typical rash and an acute pharyngitis later present versa. So scarlet fever is a bacterial infection, typically presenting with acute pharyngitis with typical rash, and it's common among school-aged children, very unusual in smaller children. And transmission is by direct contact or respiratory droplets. Like any other exanthematous illness also, this is due to direct contact or respiratory droplets. And incubation period is 2 to 5 days. So how does it present? Usually, there's an abrupt onset. The child present with high grade fever, and they also present with sore throat. Some of them may present with abdominal pain, and most of them present with pharyngitis. There's a typical presentation of pharyngitis, which is just now, and they also have cervical lymphadenopathy. Cervical lymph nodes are enlarged, and there is a typical RASCO presentation. So if you have to remember fever, high grade fever, pharyngitis, and a typical rash. So how do they present? Usually pharynx ma kya hunsa, you have a large tonsils, okay? And this tonsil will have yellow exudates. This is a postpoint, sir, the hip hunsa. Then you have petechiae and a soft palate. This is a very typical presentation of a streptococcal throat. Otherwise, sore throat. Most of us have had sore throat once in a time. Recently, every season was sore throat. But all sore throats are strep throat. Most of them are viral pharyngitis. You need to differentiate between viral pharyngitis and streptococcus pharyngitis. Viral pharyngitis, you don't need antibiotics, but for streptococcus pharyngitis, you need to give antibiotics. So a typical feature of streptococcus pharyngitis is when you clinically examine the child, your tonsils will be very, very large, and you'll have post point like this. Post point is a tonsil large vacuus of any, it is a bacterial pharyngitis. And streptococcus pharyngitis, what you see? You see petechial rash like this. Soft palate, if you see petechial rash like this, that is pathognomic for streptococcal tonsillitis, strep throat, okay? And then you have cervical lymphadenopathy. Your lymph node in the cervical region will be enlarged and tender. Large unsa, swollen unsa, tender unsa. And tongue will be coated, there will be swollen papilla. So the typical presentation is a strawberry tongue. So you have a strawberry tongue. Isma kya hunu sakcha? Tongue may be swollen, or the tongue papilla will be enlarged. So the tongue will appear like a strawberry. So isma kya ki presentation one person? Typical pharyngitis ko enlarged tonsil with yellow exudates or post points. Petechiae on the palate. The uvula may be red or swollen. There is a tender cervical lymphadenopathy, and there is a typical strawberry tongue, which is because of swelling of the tongue with enlarged papilla. So this is a typical presentation of your scarlet fever. A scarlet fever rash is also, there is a presentation, it presents as a diffuse erythroderma. Rash kaile develop garcha? Second day, usually 24 to 48 hours after the onset of symptoms. Okay? Onset of rashes, 2 days, 1 or 2 days, 24 to 48 hours after the onset of symptoms. Now, rash presentation kasto huncha? Rash is diffuse. It may be finely papular and erythematous. Body purai red huncha, and it is rough to touch. So it is also known as sandpaper-like feeling. Sandpaper like touch garda hari rough bhako jasto, when you touch the baby's rash aako thau ko trump trust garyo bhane, you will have rough textures. So you have a finely papular and erythematous eruption, which is rough on palpation. And usually rash faced or trunk mounts, that there is a circumoral pallor. See, there is a picture like this. You have a diffuse erythematous rash, which is finely papular, thulo papules around, you know, masino masino dana arasasto unsa, appears as a red, bright red rash. And if you touch it, it has a rough texture. It feels like you're touching a sandpaper. And it's typical presentation, like unsa face ma rash unsa, mouth ko waripari, there is no rash. So there is a circumoral pallor. Okay, so this is known as circumoral pallor. And the rash is more prominent in the creases of elbow, axilla, and groin. It is also known as pastia lines. They also involve palms and soles. Most of your viral exanthems, palms and soles are known. Yes. Is there a problem? Just usko like put yourself above if there is no. So what happens, more prominent diseases of elbow, exam point, and they are known as pastia lines. And what happens is it involves thumbs and sole of feet. Okay. Usually rashes occurs in viral exanthemas, your palms and soles are speared. So there are certain rashes where palms and soles are involved. Rickettsial fever good rash and scarlet fever. So even rash is even present in the palms and sole. Happens, the rash will disappear after, and it usually starts to vomit, typically in hand fever. When the rash starts to disappear, you have a skin coming off and you have features like this. Most of the time, there is a layer of skin peeling off of the hands and feet. Okay, so this is the clinical presentation of scarlet fever. So scarlet fever, my case, typical presentation is high grade fever. Child presents with sore throat. There is a lymphadenopathy and a typical rash. So what happens in pharynx? Pharynx will have, their tonsil will be enlarged with pus points, and there will be petechy in solid, and you have swollen villi, and you have a typical strawberry tongue. And you have tender cervical lymphadenopathy. And the typical presentation of rash, usually onset of fever, 24 to 48 hours pachi, rash will appear. Rash will be diffuse, finely papular, erythematous. Okay, so you have finely papular, erythematous rash, which is rough to touch, feels like you are touching a sandpaper. There is a circumoral pallor, area around the mouth is speared. Palms and soles are also involved, mostly seen in the deep creases of elbow, axilla, haru in your mouth. And when it disappears after 1 week, they slowly fade away, leaving a desquamated skin, mostly on the hands and feet. Okay, so this is the characteristics of rash or scarlet fever. Now, how do you diagnose scarlet fever? Usually there is a history of close contact. When some members of the family, if a child goes to school, somebody from the school has had a strep throat. So kasalai ghati dukheko cha, tonsil bareko cha, testo history huna sakcha, ya family members kasalai similar presentation auna sakcha. So an elderly in the family may have a streptococcal tonsillitis. The child may have gotten from that family member, and along with the streptococcal tonsillitis, the child will also have a typical rash, which is known as scarlet fever. Most of the time, there's a high prevalence in community because it's a very infectious disease, communicable disease. So you take the history of close contact, history of family history, and the gold standard of diagnosis is throat swab culture. Okay, you take a swab from the throat and you see it in a culture media, you have a streptococcal growth on a suction. Okay, so this is a gold standard media. But for swab culture to come positive, it will be at 1 or 2 days, 24 to 48 hours per se. So that is why for rapidly detecting it, we do rapid antigen detection tests in OPDs or in the lab. So it's part of swab linser, and then you put it. Then after a while, it will show a line showing whether there is a strep throat or not. So rapidly diagnosis kulai, we use rapid antigen detection test. This is the same type of kit which we use to diagnose COVID-19 को पनि rapidly diagnose गर्नु पर्यो भने instead of PCR we do rapid antigen detection test. Okay, then another method is anti-streptolysin or ASA. Anti-streptolysin or ASO titer. Okay, this is also known as ASO titer. So what happens when you have streptococcal infection? Microbiology ma pareko cha hola. And one of these is streptolysin. Okay, so you have DNA, streptolysin, all these. So these will be released when you have a streptococcal infection, and we see that in the blood. So ASO titer reaction. Okay, so this is how we diagnose strep throat, and the best method or gold standard is still throat swab culture. And for rapid detection, we do rapid antigen detection test. So how do you treat scarlet fever? Scarlet fever is bacterial infection. We have to treat with antibiotics. The choice of antibiotics is either oral penicillin. The commonly used one is amoxicillin or cephalosporin. Cephalosporin may be first or second generation cephalosporin. Cefadroxil or cefalexin. We work and we have to give 10 days. If you diagnose as a streptococcal, we have to give the antibiotic for 10 days. Okay, so choice of antibiotic is oral penicillin or cephalosporin. Most commonly used medicine is amoxicillin. If the person is the baby, his child is allergic to penicillin, the next antibiotic that we can use is macrolides. Macrolides may we use erythromycin. Okay, so this is the choice of antibiotic. So first and choice is amoxicillin. Amoxicillin sanga allergic sa bhane we use macrolides. Macrolides man we use erythromycin or azithromycin. Because this child will have high grade fever, antipyretics man dinchum we use paracetamol. So this is the treatment, and remember the duration. It is not for 5 days or 7 days. The duration should be, if you have detected group A streptococcus, you have to give the antibiotic for 10 days. Now, why is scarlet fever important? Scarlet fever is important because it has immediate complication and long-term complication. Immediate complication or local complication. Acute tonsillitis purposa, kune spread border, the child can have severe otitis media, inflammation of the middle ear. The child can develop pharyngeal abscess, cervical lymphadenopathy, inflammation can spread, and the child can develop cervical adenitis or cervical abscess. Okay, sometime if the child can also, if there is a group A streptococcal to severe infection, so if the child has not been immunized against pneumococcal vaccine, the child can develop streptococcal sepsis. Okay, then there is a long-term complication, which is not because of immediate infection. Usually what happens if a child has streptococcal throat, we need to treat this with antibiotic. If you do not treat this with antibiotic, what will happen? This child will again present with acute rheumatic fever, post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis or post-streptococcal arthritis. So this is a non-suppurative complication of scarlet fever or streptococcal throat. That is why we need to detect the streptococcal throat, and we need to start the antibiotic early and treat it for a good 10 days. For 10 days for complete treatment. Okay, so this is all about scarlet fever. So any questions? Any question? Can you hear me?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so I'll repeat one more time. Scarlet fever, it's a bacterial infection. Typical presentation is pharyngitis with rash. Causative organism is group A beta hemolytic streptococci, not group B. Group A beta hemolytic streptococci. So I'm not reviewing your microbiology. So you should know what group A GAS ki ho, GVS le organism ki cause garcha tha paunu parcha. So scarlet fever, pneumonia haru in your, these are caused by group A streptococci. Okay, and they will release a pyrogenic exotoxin. So normally school age children ma dekhincha respiratory droplets bata start huncha. Typical presentation, if you have to remember the pharyngitis, high grade fever with pharyngitis with pus point and petechiae in the throat. Then there is strawberry tongue and there is a tender cervical lymphadenopathy. If you have to remember rash, you remember rash will appear 24 to 48 hours. Dui din pachi rash appear huncha. Then there is a diffuse erythroderma. Diffuse erythroderma papular huncha, rough to touch. There is circumoral pallor, usually elbows haru, necks haru, axilla ma bari dekhincha. And when they disappear with desquamation. Okay, there is a peeling off of skin. And this rash will affect palms and soles as well. Diagnosis is by gold standard of diagnosis is throat culture. Throat bata swab lera culture media ma streptococcus grow gare pachi, that is how we diagnose. But it takes time. So sometimes if we have to diagnose early OPD basis ma, we do rapid antigen detection test. And we can also do it by ASO titer. ASO titer, anti-DNase B titer, all that these can be done. Okay, again, this for this you need to know about microbiology. Microbiology per se, then you know what are the enzymes or what are the things that the streptococcus secrete karera, this is essay ko essay karne. Okay, and treatment. Treatment, mainstay of treatment is antibiotics. Kun antibiotics? Oral penicillin or cephalosporin. Oral penicillin ma amoxicillin dinchum. Kati duration? 10 days. Remember this. If allergic to penicillin, next choice of antibiotic is macrolides. Macrolides ma erythromycin or azithromycin. Complication ma, remember the local complication. It can spread and cause otitis media. It can be severe enough to cause pharyngeal abscess. Sometimes it can cause cervical abscess. It can also cause pneumonia. And if it becomes invasive, if it goes to the bloodstream, it can cause severe sepsis. Non-suppurative cause. You suppose this we will be discussing in detail later on, but non-suppurative cause, you have a strep throat, the child was not treated, and then after 2 or 3 weeks, the child may develop acute rheumatic fever, post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis, and post-streptococcal arthritis. Okay, so this is all about scarlet fever. Now the next one is varicella or chickenpox. This is also very important. The cause is a DNA virus, herpes virus, which is also known as varicella zoster virus. Okay, this is a DNA virus, herpes family ma huncha. So causative organism is a varicella zoster virus. Transmission is again airborne or direct contact. You have chickenpox ko rashes or rash or but a direct contact bhayo bhane, you can have chickenpox. Incubation period is 10 to 21 days. And 90% of the children is between 1 to 14 years, and it is very highly contagious. If somebody has chickenpox, if you have come in contact with a baby with chickenpox, euta family member le chickenpox bhayeko chha bhane, the chance of spreading to other family member is very, very high. Or daycare centers, haruma, school, haruma, kasaile chickenpox aako chha bhane, if the babies are not vaccinated, chances of spreading is very, very high. So remember, varicella zoster virus, a DNA virus, and direct contact but a spread huncha and very contagious. So pahile samma infective huncha ta, so we need to isolate these patients, right? So when is the period of infectivity? Period of infectivity is rash auna 2 din agari dekhi, so 2 days prior to rash and 5 days after cross formation the child will be infected. 2 days prior to rash formation, the last summer, cross summer, the child will be infected. Jun last ma black color ko scab form huncha, which is non-infected. I'll again tell this later. Okay, the importance of varicella zoster is you have a lifelong latent infection in the sensory ganglia. Because it is a DNA virus, any herpes virus, now what happens if you are infected with chickenpox? The chickenpox, the virus will go and stay in your sensory ganglia. So it will be there lifelong. Lifelong immunity pani create karso. Once it is there in the sensory ganglia, whenever you are immunocompromised condition ma hunda heri flare up huncha. So that flaring up is known as shingles. Janai khatera huncha, so you have that. Okay, so remember this. Once you have a chickenpox, your chickenpox virus, varicella zoster virus, stays in your body lifelong. Where do they stay? They stay in the sensory ganglia. Nervous system ko sensory ganglia huncha. Sensory ganglia ma kaha kaha huncha? Anybody, can anybody tell me where the sensory ganglia are located? Can anyone tell me? Or do I need to call the roll numbers? Okay, role number one, Akansha Singh. Can anyone tell me where are the sensory ganglia located? Akansha, is she there?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, where are the sensory ganglia located?
Cervical.
Yeah, you have it in cervical. You have it all along your spinal cord, right? Cervical, thoracic, lumbar, talasamma also, right? Do you remember? The iliac ganglia, talasamma also. So along with the spinal nerves, you have cervical ganglia. So it can, it is also there in your cranial nerves, Arma. So throughout your nervous system, you have lots of cervical sensory ganglia. This becomes important later when you study about shingles. Okay. So clinical features, how does it affect? First, because this is a viral disease, it presents with a prodrome. The baby presents with fever, malaise, anorexia. Then it rash appears. Rash appears within 24 hours. Below by 48 hours, otherwise it appears in the first day of fever. First day of fever, my rash appearance. So what will happen? Centripetal spread will succumb. Yes, Amrit, what is it? Somebody raised a hand.
Ma'am, sensory root ganglia and paravertebral ganglia are same.
Yes.
Dorsal root ganglia.
Dorsal root ganglia. Those are the sensory ganglia. Yes. So those dorsal root ganglia are the sensory ganglias. Bujo, na? So it is there in the cranial nerves as well, not just spinal nerves. It is there in the cranial nerves as well.
Okay.
So exanthem rash occurs within 24 hours. So first day of fever, mane rash appearance. And there is a centripetal spread. Centripetal spread, when you kyo? Pahila trunk mounts. You have it in the trunk. Mukma na dekhina saksa. If you do not see the chest, you tend to miss out the rash on the first day. So usually trunk ma first ma appear unsa, trunk pata, then it spreads to the extremities. That is why it is known as centripetal. Opposite ma centrifugal unsa. Mukma paila dekhine trunk ma pachi auni lai centrifugal bansa, but this is centripetal. It appears in the trunk first, then it appears in the face and extremities. Okay, and it appears in this manner. Suruma, you will only see a reddish rash like this, papule. A reddish rash like this, macular unsa, then it becomes papule, then it will be filled with liquid. So it is known as vesicle, and that liquid will turn into pus, then it will be pustules, and your pustules phute pasi, the liquid will be crusted, dry, brownish, yellowish type of crust unsa. This is known as crust. Okay, so this is how the progression of the rash occur in chickenpox. So you have a papule, reddish rash in a success, especially papule also, then vesicle, clear fluid fill also, then pustule, and then there is crust. Pustule for tipasi, when the dried up liquid will be yellowish, there is dried up crust formation. So this is your crust. So after the crust, what happens? Then scab. When you have any wound, you have scab formation. Later scab formation pa in a success, crust some infective and so scab is not infective. So up to here the child is infecting. So it appear in crops. Okay, ekai chuti aundaina, so it appears in crops. Euta thau ma auncha, that will settle down, and again rest of the thau ma auncha. Because of that, what happens is, like, it appears in crops like this. Okay, so some areas will have papules with up, because at a time ek thau ma appear huncha, despachi ek din pachi arko thau ma appear huncha, despachi arko thau ma appear huncha. That is why at some area you'll have papules, see, at some area you'll have vesicles, at some area you'll have pustules, and some areas ma you'll have crust. So it appears in the different stages. This is known as pleomorphic rash. Okay, pleomorphic rash is pathognomic for varicella. Jiu bhari papule, whole body bhari pustules, whole body bhari vesicles aundaina. Some area ma there is papule, some area there is vesicle, and some area it is crust. That is as pleomorphic rash, and it is pathognomic for varicella. And rash will fade away with just a hypopigmented lesion. Scarring is unusual. Scarring occur if there is a secondary infection. Usually chickenpox ko dag bastaina. Dag kina basta? When what happens, it is very itchy. The rash is very, very itchy. Pruritus is present. And what happens? The babies will itch. Itch kari sakepasi, there will be secondary infection. इन्फेक्शन भइसकेपछि चाहिँ नि यु क्यान ह्याभ स्कारिङ द्याट इज वाइ वी आस्क द मदर नट टु अलाउ द चाइल्ड टु इच इफ देयर इज अ सेकेन्डरी इन्फेक्शन वी निड टु ट्रिट विथ एन्टिबायोटिक्स ओके एन्ड अनदर थिङ यु निड टु नो इज म्युकोजा इज अल्सो इन्भल्भ वेन एभर देयर इज चिकन पक्स नट जस्ट युर स्किन your oral mucosa is also involved sometimes your gi mucosa is also involved that is why the child also present with abdominal pain gastritis hun sakcha even lungs harma affect garera pneumonia hun sakcha okay so it is not just exanthem it is also an enanthem because mucosa is also involved okay so this is the chicken pox typical presentation of chicken pox okay so what happens is you have fever and malaise And first day of fever, mana you'll have rash. When rash kasari auncha centripetal. So you may tend to miss out. Mukhma aaudhai, trunk ma euta dui ta aaudhai miss huna sakcha. Trunk ma first ma auncha, extremities ma pachi spread huncha. This is the progression of the rash. Papule, vesicle, pustule, and crust. And it appears in crops. That is why you have different stages of rash at a time. So it is known as pleomorphic rash. It fades away without scarring. Scarring occurs when there is secondary infection, and it is very, very itchy, and the mucosa is involved. Mucosa involved, because you can have oral ulceration as well. So this is your chicken pox. This is a typical presentation of the rash. You only severe form now. Now, what are the complications? Most common complication is secondary skin infection. Since it is very, very itchy, babies are itch cursor, scratch cursor, and you have secondary infection with streptococcus. Group A streptococcus, the secondary infection on the sucker. You can have staphylococcal infection. So most common complication is secondary skin infection. Then you have rashes like this, big purulent rash on the sucker. Okay, so the child can also develop pneumonia. These are consolidation pneumonia. Since it involves the mucosa as well, you can have pneumonia. Sometimes the child will also develop aseptic meningitis, viral meningitis develop on the sucker, and because of aseptic meningitis and encephalitis, the child can also develop acute cerebellar ataxia. This means post chicken pox, alikati hinna nasakne, hinda hindai lorne, testo hun sakcha. That is because of post viral pachi usually huncha. This is because of acute cerebellar ataxia. Sometimes the child can also develop transverse myelitis or Guillain-Barré syndrome. Okay, so this child will present with sudden onset of paralysis. So these will be we will be talking in detail in nervous system. So what are the complications? Most common is secondary skin infection, pneumonia, aseptic meningitis, acute cerebral ataxia, transverse myelitis, and Guillain-Barré syndrome. So how do we treat it? Before treatment, we have to know two more term: neonatal varicella and congenital varicella. Okay, infectious period कहिले हुन्छ? अघि कहिले भने त infectious period rash आउनु दुई दिन अगाडि, 2 days prior to the onset of rash, 2 days after cross infection. That period of infectivity. इति दिनसम्म the child will be infectious. So you need to isolate the child. You can't send the child to school. Up to 5 days after cross formation. Now rash could 2 days most of us will miss, but you have to remember this. But the child is still infective, even though if the rash is not present, chicken pox aayo bhane 1-2 days agadi school gairacha bhane the babies who are in contact with this child need to be quarantined. So because infectious period is 2 days before onset of rash, 5 days after the cross formation. What is neonatal varicella? Neonatal varicella, Vaniko, you will be studying this in gynecology as well. The baby can have chicken pox infection if the mother has varicella 5 days prior and 2 days after the delivery. Sorry, this is not rash, this is delivery. So, mommy like delivery bhako 5 din delivery hunu 5 din agari chicken pox aako ra delivery bhaisakeko 2 din pachi chicken pox aayo bhane then rash appear bhayo bhane. The baby can also have neonatal varicella, and neonatal varicella is life threatening. Okay, so baby will go into severe sepsis, and sometimes mortality can also occur. So that is why you need to be very vigilant. If mommy like delivery bako डेलिभरी हुनुभन्दा पाँच दिन अगाडि र डेलिभरी भइसकेको दुई दिनपछि चिकन पक्स भयो भने वी अज्युम द्याट द बेबी विल अल्सो डेभलप न्युनेटल भ्यारिसेला एन्ड वी स्टार्ट द बेबी अन भ्यारिसेला इम्युनोग्लोबुलिन. Now there is another term known as congenital varicella. Just like congenital rubella syndrome, congenital varicella is when mother like first trimester, first 20 weeks of gestation ma chicken pox bhayo bhane, the growing fetus will be affected and so will have some congenital abnormality. So they will have some psychiatrical means, they will have some skin lesions. Excuse me. Psychiatrical means there is a scar formation. So there is band formation, fibrous tissue band formation type of skin lesion. There may be limb deformities, hypoplasia of extremities. There may be limb deformities. You can have microphthalmia, small eye, or cataract in the eye. So you can have brain calcification, intracranial calcification. Okay. So if the mother has chickenpox during first trimester of pregnancy, there are some congenital malformation that can occur in the baby. Most common is the limb deformity, scarring of the limbs, eye microphthalmia and cataract, and intracranial brain calcification. So another thing you have to know is herpes zoster. So herpes zoster is another name is shingles. Okay, herpes zoster is also known as shingles. Nepali ma it is also known as janai khatela. So what is happening? So you remember your sensory ganglia, okay? So what happens when you have a varicella infection? You have varicella infection, bachcha ma varicella chicken pox bhayo, but the varicella zoster virus will remain inside your body lifelong. Where do they stay? They will stay in a latent form, not an active form, inactive form in your sensory ganglia. So sensory ganglia ma bascha. So what happens? There is a whenever you have immunocompromised state, ekdam dherai birami bhako cha, you have stressful condition ma bascha, stressful condition bhara, you are in a exam ko agari, when you have a lot of stress, or when you have had severe illness, or when you're taking steroids, immunocompromised stage, there is a reactivation of the virus from the sensory ganglia. And what will happen? Your sensory ganglia le jun dermatome lai spread gareko cha. Do you remember your dermatome from your anatomy? Dermatome bhaneko samjhecha ki yaad cha ki chaina? Yes or no? Do you remember dermatome? Skin. A region of the skin supplied by single knob is known as dermatome. There is a typical dermatome presentation in your anatomy. Go back to your anatomy or neuroanatomy and remember the dermatome. So what happens is, if that sensory vesicular rash of this particular sensory ganglia is activated, you have a papular rash along the same dermatome. That is why, since it follows a particular dermatome, it is known as janai khatera. So maybe this child has no sensory ganglia that affect bhakosa, so this is following a particular dermatome. It doesn't spread here or there, but it follows the dermatome of that sensory ganglia. Okay, so this is known as shingles. So this is basically reactivation of the latent virus from the sensory ganglia. And this shingles is very, very painful. Since it is a rash affecting the nervous system, it is very painful. It is neurotropic pain, and usually the paracetamol, ibuprofen, you may have to give amitriptyline for the pain. Okay, so how do you diagnose varicella zoster? Most of the time the diagnosis is clinical. Okay, we do not send any investigation. Most of the time, the diagnosis is clinical. So if you have to confirm the diagnosis, we confirm it with PCR or immunoglobulin antibody. And we also send Jang smear. Now, Jang smear is, this is common for all herpes virus. This is similar for all the herpes virus. Herpes simplex ma pani same unso, herpes zoster ma pani same unso. Okay, so most of the diagnosis is done clinically. Normally, we do not send all this investigation. Now, what is the treatment? Treatment is generally symptomatic. So smaller babies, we do not give any antiviral. Bigger babies, we prefer to give acyclovir. Acyclovir is an antiviral, which is specific for herpes virus. So symptomatic treatment, we give paracetamol for antipyretic. Since it is very, very itchy, we give some antihistamine like cetirizine or fexofenadine, and we make sure that the child maintains good hygiene. Usually chickenpox on the gum side raksa. You should not do that. You should give the baby proper bath, clean garni, ekdam full lugarin alauni, because if you have secondary skin infection, problem ki huncha, the chances the child developing scarring is very high. You have secondary skin develop opsi, long time summer, your lifelong summer, you can have scar of the chickenpox. If you do not have secondary skin infection, normally scar hundaina. Then you need to isolate the child, okay? Since this is an infectious disease, you need to isolate the child. Isolation kaile samma garne? Infectious period samma. So rash aunu dui din agadi, that is not possible. So crust formation bhako, mask din samma pani isolate garne. So sabai assume gari, if all the crust formation bhako, last crust formation bhako, after that also for up to 5 days, the child